Flowflex is designed for the foot and ankle, but it works with the rest of your body. It works to make sure that you're creating the proper pressure through your feet for all motion. And when you do that, it allows you to move better. It allows you to function better. It allows you to squat better, walk better, stand better. Whatever it is you do, it makes you do it better. It makes it do it correct. So even if you're standing at your desk and you're working at home right now, you can stand in the stance position on the Moflex and you'll actually align yourself more ideally and put less pressure on your body, on your lower back, on your knees, on your feet, all these types of things. It's when we don't align or don't create proper pressure in our bodies when our whole body starts to really suffer from it. So Moflex is a great tool just for standing. It improves our balance, it improves lots of things. So I'm gonna get started today. In today's class, we're gonna go through the basic functions of Moflex. We call it the basic four. We'll see what kind of time we have to expand that to the total basic seven. But I'm gonna get started and we're gonna go through it and I'm gonna kind of give some background on what to look for. So like I said, I'm barefoot, so we're gonna start that way. And if everybody's ready to get started, we'll go ahead and get started. All right, so first thing we need to understand is Moflex has tiers. All right, there's gaps between each of those tiers. And those gaps are the same impression that your foot makes. You only create contact in your heel and ball of the foot in a stance position. The only time the toe really gets involved is when we're actually propelling ourselves or moving. And that allows us to kind of catapult our motion. So it's really important that we create ideal pressure through heel and the ball of our foot. The ball of our foot is right below the toes. So there's two points, the outer point of the foot, the inner point of the foot. So when you're going to get on Moflex, and what I recommend is for beginners, for everybody to start at that first tier, okay? So if I were to place my heel down and place the ball of my foot, so right below that pinky toe and right below the big toe is where I want that pressure. And for most, your other toe, and for some, your other toe should be able to touch that at next tier. Try to get it at least touching the edge of it if your foot's a little shorter. And if your foot's longer, it should extend almost up and over that next tier. So holding that position. Also look that the foot is completely straight on the Moflex. We don't want to toe out. We don't want to toe in. And another really important factor is we want to make sure that we feel pressure on the outside of the ball of the foot and the inside ball of the foot. Now, if right now you're in shoes, look for that first shoelace. At that first shoelace, that's the ball of your foot. And that shoelace should be right at the top of that tier there, along those lines. Right where it says Moflex, that's your tier point, okay? So putting that foot there, we're in a good starting position. Let's bring our other foot on. Again, lining up straight, bringing our body tall, feeling the weight in our heels, but then also feeling the weight on either side of the ball of the foot, so below the big toe and below the little toe. And now I'm in a nice, relaxed position. For some that have not proper pressure in their feet, you'll see that the hips are gonna stick out. So if your hips are sticking out right now, it's okay, just get that position, bend the knees a little bit, and then try to straighten yourself up a little bit. This first tier, people should be able to accomplish, especially if you're in shoes. Barefoot a little harder, but holding that position, holding that alignment, holding your body nice and straight. And this is something you can do watching TV. This is something you can do while you're working at your desk. Really great starting position and a really great warm-up before you start to exercise too. So holding that position, this is basically kind of warm-up. If we don't stand good, we can't move good. From that good solid position, let's take our right foot back off. Keeping our left on there, we're gonna go right into gait now. So walking, or motions of transfer, how we transfer our weight from one side to the other. So holding that foot on there, okay? We're gonna bring, this is called loading right now. We're loading that foot, we're going to take a step. This is great for runners, walkers. If you're taking walks, this is a great thing, because I think everyone started walking more. I know I have, around our neighborhood with the boys and everything. So this is a great prep tool to do before or after your walks or runs or activity. So in a loading position, we go into what's called mid-stance. This is when we go to take a step. So this other foot is in the air right now, but on the Moflex, it's sitting, and it's splitting basically it's sitting right in the arch of the foot. So all my weight is on this left side right now, holding that position, holding myself tall. This is a great way and position to practice single leg balance. This is a really good way to focus on or work on improving your balance by just holding this position. The next movement we do, and we hold that for about 15 seconds, all right, and holding that, keeping your body straight. Things to look for is your hips might stick out because you don't have the proper pressure in the foot and that ankle can't create the right angle, or that hip might start to open up. Make sure that hip is straight and it lines up with the tier of the Moflex, and you keep those hips in, all right? Make sure those glutes are working too. This is all the body working, not just the feet and ankles. Everything is kinetically connected. The next thing we're gonna do is go into what we call terminal. This is when our weight shifts. This is right before we go to put our foot down. This is a great stretch to create balance and create function. That back foot, that heel's still down. There's more pressure now into the ball of the foot of the back foot because I'm getting ready to start to move forwards onto my other foot. We're holding this terminal phase for about 15 seconds, keeping the body straight, splitting the body in two, front to back, right at the apex, the top of the Moflex, holding that position, keeping the hips straight, trying not to let them stick out, trying for them not to turn sideways, keeping right in position. From this position, we're gonna go into a heel strike, which is pre-swing. So then we're gonna go forwards, heel's gonna touch down, back foot is still touching. We're gonna then put our pressure down, holding that position. Now I've got a lot more pressure on that back foot, on that back heel. So there's a lot more pressure going on there now than in the heel. It's starting to transfer through the foot, but I'm still creating that stretch, still creating that position. The front foot is now planted, so now I'm getting a certain amount of load pressure on that front foot. We're holding that for about 15 seconds. Again, watch that the hips don't stick out. Watch that you're not rotating, okay? And watch that that heel's not coming up. Keep that heel down. Make sure it's still against the ground. Not easy. The next thing we're gonna do is then go through a what's called a swing phase. So slowly come up with that back foot so that those toes extend. It'll really teach your toes how to work properly, especially the big toe. That's what creates the motion to move forwards and to spring off and take a step. Let's try that again. This time, let's load with our right foot. Okay. All right, so I'll check in with everybody that's on in a second. Let's go through this one. So the loading, again, the ball of the foot on that tier, okay? And like I said, where does the ball go? Right if it underlined the Moflex label. For me right now on this right side, I don't have a label, but I can see where it is. My toe's just kind of saying hello to that next tier. My pressure's there. I'm standing straight forwards, holding that position. This is called load. This one is easy for everybody. Then it starts getting hard. Here goes the balance one. This is mid-stance where our foot goes up on top. Our back foot is still loading. I still have pressure in my heel. I've got the left foot now on top of the Moflex, holding my body nice and straight. Trying not to let it twist, trying to keep the buttocks in, holding that position. Again, great exercise to work on single leg balance. Super easy to do, super effective. You can even take it a little advanced by raising the foot up and down to really work on your balance. A lot safer than just holding yourself on one leg, and you know you've got the proper pressure in the back foot, or I should say the stance foot. Next, we're gonna go into terminal. This foot comes down the other side. Now my toes and ball of the foot are on the ground, where now my heel is coming up onto the Moflex. And if it feels more comfortable for you, mimic the same thing as your other side is doing. So your heel is on that first tier. The ball of the foot is on the ground. Remember, make sure those feet are pointing straight. Something we always have to understand and we always have to keep in our minds. Our knees are hinges like a door. A hinge on a door can only go forwards and back. It can't go side to side. As soon as you turn that foot out or turn that foot in, you're now creating pressure on that hinge. And this is what leads to knee problems. And when you put pressure on the knee, pressure also goes to the hip and lower back, which causes a lot of our hip and lower back problems. So if you toe out or toe in, MoFlex is definitely a tool that you should be using to work on creating proper toe sequence, meaning foot straight forward. From terminal, from this position, we're gonna go into heel strike again. So the heel comes down, that's hard to do, I know. Back leg's a little bit bent, I just lost my balance, it's all right. Holding that position, then bring that foot down, okay? Holding the body in a straight position, trying not to let the hips come out, trying to keep the body straight. A lot of us, when we walk, we just kind of fall over. When we go to walk, we just kind of tip our bodies forwards. That's not the proper way to move, okay? Falling over is not how we move. But runners do it, people that walk do it. We want to create power with that back foot. And the only way to create, you know, motor or push is by having that back foot contact the actual ground, okay? And if my heel's up right now, I'm not pushing forwards. I would need my body to lean over for me to go forwards. So it's so important. We call the heel our accelerators, and we call the toes and ball of the foot our brakes. Our brakes create like the catapult, or I shouldn't say the pole vault. It allows us to spring to the next step. That's why when we're sprinting, we're typically on the balls of our feet, but when we're jogging or walking, we're definitely heel striking to create motor power. Once we get to sprint, we're just carrying load because we've already got to that speed. So holding that position, we'll go into swing and come through. Awesome job, everybody. Really good. I see a lot of people here watching. Make sure you're asking me questions. If you want me to slow down, I know I say too much information typically, but it's really good stuff to understand and know. You should always know what you're working on. But thanks everybody for joining. Please ask questions. I've got Ashley monitoring questions, so you can spit out your questions as I'm going, and I'll answer them as I'm going through this. So feel free. Let's create a two-way street here. Is everybody ready to move to the next step? Next step is hinging, okay? Now, Mike and Taylor, Casey, Heather, Tyler, Sharon, I think everybody does this one better than me, but I think that's the only one you guys do better than me. So hinging, all right, because I'm older than everybody. If we put our feet on that first tier again, let's line them up, balls of the feet on, okay? Toe saying hello to that second tier. Now, granted, you can go to the second tier. You know, if Mike was tuned in right now, he'd be probably at the third tier, all right? But we'll talk about that later. All right, so let's go to that first tier again. Holding that position. All right, we're gonna go to a hinging motion. Hinging is the first part of bending. Okay, we hinge for a lot of exercises that we do at Club Fit. Okay, we do RDLs where we come over and we row and we come up. We do toe touches. We do a lot of hip hinge. It's really an important motion, but it creates horrible pressure to the back and knees if it's not done right. So really important is to be able to create the proper position, and doing that is creating the proper pressure through the feet. Hold on, we have a question.
Nancy Shade. Is barefoot better than with shoes? If barefoot, I can only stay on first tier or I slip off.
Okay. Nancy, thanks for the question. Okay, so barefoot compared to shoes. Barefoot is better because there's nothing between you and the proper pressure that you should be applying. A really minimal shoe means a very flat shoe, okay? Like a Converse shoe or other ones that are very flat sole. Those are probably the next best, and then leading up. But whatever you feel comfortable in, if you don't exercise or move or run around barefoot a lot, then I wouldn't recommend going barefoot first. I would go through the stages from a normal tennis shoe and even stay there. You're still creating good pressure, okay? It just contours to improper places in your foot. Soles in a shoe typically take up areas in the bottom of your foot that you shouldn't be putting pressure on, like the arch of your foot. You never want to fill in the arch because that collapses the bridge. The foot has two pillars, a heel and a ball of the foot. If we put pressure in the middle of that bridge, the bridge collapses. And pressure goes out in two ways, which creates a chain reaction of the body that causes all kinds of deficits. Now, great, For a lot of people that put inserts in your shoe, it comforts impact and it feels better. But what it's doing is it's slowly breaking down your kinetic sequence of your body and how it works. So when you get the back pain, you'll think, oh, I did something to my back. Typically, you stopped creating proper pressure in your feet that created too much distribution of pressure to your back. And that's why we end up hurting our back, especially when we go to do an action. So definitely try in bare feet, but if your feet are slipping off or you're having trouble holding that, and typically the feet slip off because you just don't have the range, or they slip down, or if you try to get higher, when they start to slide, it typically you don't have that range yet. So yeah, back off to the first tier and work your way back up to that. All right, guys, hinging. I hope that answers your question, Nancy. Okay, and if it doesn't, ask me again. Holding that position, balls of the feet on, toes kind of touching, and if they're not touching, it's okay. If you feel the Moflex come up and it starts to move, we designed it to definitely do that because that means your foot's not on there enough, all right? So if you feel that front, keep doing this. Get your feet on there more. Slide up on it more because you're not creating the proper pressure. This is all designed biomechanically to understand the pressure in your feet. All right, hinge. So holding the feet straight, hips back, heels in contact with pressure, we're gonna slowly bring our hips back behind us. That's the first part of hinge, keeping the back straight, keeping the back arched, okay? We'll start to reach down, but what we don't want is the back to roll. We don't want that to happen because all the pressure comes to our back then. And I see this way too much in the club, people doing hip motions with a bent back. We call this a kyphotic back. We want lordosis. We want a lordotic back. We want an arched back when we're doing a hinge motion, keeping a straight back, reaching towards the floor, touching, and coming up. You notice my knees are slightly bent. It's okay. You don't want them hyperextended out because that puts too much pressure on these knees. And with too much pressure, it can cause the knee to hyperextend and cause a lot of issues. Our knees are hinges. They can go both ways. But we're biomechanically designed to keep it from going two ways, only one way, flexion. So we want to make sure that we're not too straight at the knees, a little bit bent, coming over, straight back. Take your head and look towards the ground so you're not straining your neck. But if you need to, look into a mirror, okay, and you'll have the perception then to see where you're at, which makes the exercise a little bit easier, or looking to the side. Reaching down and then coming up. Let's try about 10 of these. So back with the hips, back straight, and back up. Watch that the feet are still staying in contact the proper ways. Watch that they're not sliding out to the sides. Watch that they're not turning in. Watch that they're not rolling over, rolling out to the sides. You don't want that either. You want that pressure really good. Teaching foot pressure and ankle range of motion and mobility is critical no matter what exercise or movement you do. Whether it's yoga you enjoy doing, whether it's weight training, whether it's walking the dog, whatever movements you do, having proper pressure through your feet is critical to saving your body and keeping it efficient for long term. This is something we've known since the 1800s, but there's never really been any way or any device to really train that. And getting up on a wobble board and wobbling around or in a Bosu, that's not helping. You're just exploiting your problems. Let's try two more. I never could count. I'm gonna go last one. Awesome hinges, everybody. All right, now we're starting to feel a little bit loose. Those are three of the basic four fundamental movements that we do in life. Not just Moflex, this is just fundamental movement. I'm just making sure with this device that I'm creating the proper pressure when I'm doing these movements. So I'm training these movements or prepping these movements for when I do them for whatever else I do, or I can do them with an exercise. Right now, Major League Baseball, this is something they do before they do their strength and conditioning or before they go out to the cage and do their batting. Same with most sports. This is how we prep. This is how we get our bodies engaged and ready to move properly. Next thing we're gonna do is a squatting motion. So that's a hinge to a bend in the knee. even further than we did before. So really, a squat's just a variation and a double joint motion to a hinge. So holding those feet, this is the one I'm gonna show off a little bit. The pressure on there, okay, feet straight, hips are back. This is an important motion to people. And for those I've heard so many times, I don't like squatting. Oh, you don't like getting up and down from a chair? You can't get up and down from it? That's so important to function right now. And for all of us that are sitting and watching the news and all these other things, we're atrophying every day. So it's really important that we keep working on squats and not just squatting, squatting correctly with the proper pressure to the heel and ball of the foot. So when we go down into this motion, let's lower down. So the hips go back, knees start to bend. So it looks like we're starting to hinge. But what happens is our spine straightens out into the squatting motion as we go through it. And we go down to wherever we feel comfortable and then raise back up. I do not expect anybody to go that low. So go where your body stays straight up, okay? So as soon as you get to a position where you start to lower that head, no, you don't want to go any lower than that, all right? So only go until your head keeps straight. As soon as you see it starting to come forward and those hips start to raise, you're no longer squatting, now you're hinging. So we want to squat. So drive the hips underneath us. So for most of us, this is probably as low as we really need to go, that we're creating the proper pressure. You might feel your feet starting to roll out on this one, or your knees starting to collapse in. Make sure everything is lining up straight and coming back up through it. So again, squatting down, extend those arms, and then back up. If you feel more comfortable, go to your kitchen sink, hold on. Grab the back of a couch. Do something that can help you balance and stabilize, because what's going on right now is everything's forcing me to fall backwards. Most of our bodies are not used to creating this proper pressure. And you've heard it many times in the gym, hey, squat towards your heels. What that means is, activate your posterior kinetic chain, those hamstrings, those glute muscles, all the muscles that stabilize our body. As soon as we go to the ball of the foot, now we're putting all the pressure on our knees, and that's why our knees hurt when we squat. And for so many, that's why people stop squatting. And for so many, it's why people have to push up to get out of a chair. Shouldn't have to do that. Going down, and then back up, going down, back up, try five more, back up, two more, let's try one last one. That's awesome, everybody. All right, those are our basic four, all right? Now you really know how to do basic four, and you know why you need to do basic four. We're gonna go into number five. The fifth fundamental movement is rotation. How we rotate the body. All right, these are all principal body motions. Let's put our feet back in those same spots. You can go wider, you can go narrower. A lot of people ask me that question too. Should my feet be close together or far apart? For the stance motions, keep your feet about shoulder width. That's right outside your hips, or right in line with your hips. A lot of people go, oh, out here? No, my shoulders are here. Also, with the gait motion, you can be in narrower stance. The wider you go, the more stability you have, but you should be more narrow, like you're taking a walk. Never practice something that you wouldn't apply to life. So practice it in the way you do it for life. The next thing you want to do for rotation is, let's put both feet on. We're going to do a lying stance. Okay, you guys have probably done torso rotations 100 times in the gym. You know why? Because it's a fundamental movement pattern. All right, it's part of the way our bodies work. And everything from that is a variation. So, hold that position. Let's take our hands out in front of us. Get the hips a little bit bent, all right? Because we don't want to start to lean forwards here. We want to stay nice and straight. So a little bit soft in the knees and hips. Let's extend out. And when we do that, this leg extends, all right, so the knee straightens, this leg bends. So as I go to my left, all right, where my hands are going, this knee is bending, this knee is extending. And that's how we generate force from the ground up through our body, and that's how we create a longer drive if we're golfing, That's how we create a proper motion that doesn't hurt her spine if we're just moving. So this is really important. So bend this knee and drive this leg and extend to the side. Go the opposite. Let's extend the right, bend the left. Really important to understand how to move correctly to prevent injury and to improve your performance. And when I say improve performance, I don't mean sports performance. I just mean movement performance. How you perform, whether you're dancing, whether you're playing a sport, whether you're walking, whatever you're doing. So back and forth with that extension. See how those legs are moving? This is how we're supposed to move, not here. This trains our core correctly. Our core is just a connection between our lower extremity and our upper extremity. Really important to focus on using our core correctly, because our hips, which we call our hip girdle and our shoulder girdle, this middle part creates motion from the ground when we're standing to create force out our hands and then up through our feet. So we extend our energy and power up through their feet, out through the hands. So if I throw a baseball, I'm generating power not from my arm, but from the ground. Because if I was up in the air and tried to throw, I have no power. Unless I'm Francisco Lindor. All right, so extending over with this leg, extending straight, bending. Everybody just keep on moving with that. Not easy to coordinate, but really good. Awesome. Let's do a split stance, okay? We call it staggered stance. Right foot's in the back, pressure there. Front foot's in the front. Let's create the motion correctly. So the heel, if you're on the first tier, the heel is on that first tier, ball of foot's below it, okay? So then the back of my heel's just touching that second tier. Feet are straight, okay? I'm lined up. I'm gonna extend back. So here, extending and bending, and then coming through, all right? Here we can't extend this, so it's really just a one side rotation. So back extension and coming through. So reaching back to grab that seat belt and then coming through and putting it on. For those that don't have range of motion, they say, well, I sit when I do that. Yeah, but guess what? Because you can't do it standing, you can't do it seated either. And when you're seated, you're shutting off your lower half. And if you don't teach that lower half how to work, it's not gonna work right. And back, and that leads to those shoulder rotator issues from reaching with our arm instead of our body. One more, awesome, let's switch the feet. Same thing, ball the foot in the back, heel against second tier. Arches gaps because it's supposed to be, it's a bridge. We're gonna extend on this side with this leg, flex on the other side. Extend and flex. Really important. If you like the golf, this will add 8 miles an hour to your drive in 30 days, as well as 30 yards. I was actually just told that by the director of the PGA Junior National Team. In 30 days, he started hitting it longer just by doing these exercises. So Nancy, do them in your golf shoes then. Going back, extending. Please feel free to ask questions. And yes, you can do these in your golf shoes as long as they're not steel spikes. But you could, it'd ruin the Moflex if you ordered another one. Coming through, here we go. One thing I didn't mention yet, which we have, Ashley's gonna put it up there. We have a special for everyone that's tuned in today, and it's a special discount. While this is going on right now, and I should have done it already, so I'll extend it past the class, anyone that orders a Moflex during the class will get 50% off their Moflex. So if you enter code CLUBFIT, all capital letters, into the promo code area, discount code, 50% off your purchase. But for most of you, you already have one. And you're already using it, but you can always use another one. I can show you how to use two together. It's really great. Coming through, let's go back. And extend. Awesome. Two styles of rotation. There's lots. There's lots of movements we can do, but I really just wanted to go over the basics today. A lot of people ask me, Phil, you're crazy. Push-pull? How is upper body motion have anything to do with lower body? Well, it has everything to do with it, because it's how we stabilize. And I've seen so many people in here lunge too far into the balls of their feet and not be able to control their motion. And they're doing a press lunge or something, and they're all their weight's in that front foot. MoFlex teaches you where to keep that pressure and weight when you're doing it. So if we do a push motion, let's get back in that lined up position, and we go to extend our arms out. Watch my hips. My weight stays back in these heels, and I'm extending through. I'm positioned and stable, and I'm strong in that push position. So straight, pushing out. With a proper sequence of our pressure in our feet, it'll save our back. When we go to push the couch around, or we have to move an object, really, really important. Same thing can be applied when we pull. So holding this position and rowing in. So what I'm trying to say is, just about every exercise you do, you could train while on the MoFlex to make sure that you're getting the proper activation to the rest of your body. So, so important. So, so important. So my body's just doing the opposite of what I just did. Obviously, since now I'm pulling, which is an opposite motion, coming in and straightening up. So if you're doing a band exercise and you're rowing in, you know that you're getting full activation through your body if you're doing it here. If I'm not on here and I'm all the way here, I've locked up my calves now. I've locked up my body now in my lower half. My upper body is going to start to sway. I'm going to put pressure in my back. If I'm on the MoFlex, it stabilizes my body. It puts me in a position that I know that I'm going to get activation to the rest of my body. As soon as I lose my pressure position, I shut down how my body works, and it's really bad for it. Something else that a lot of people don't think about, and we're going to go into an eighth movement, is our ankles. Our ankles don't just do this, and they really don't do that. They don't just go forwards and back. They actually rotate to do that. It's called pronation. And we can underpronate, we can overpronate. And it's really important that our feet pronate and that we have control of that rotation. When we don't have control, especially when we're walking or running, we can really strain our feet, ankles, knees, hips, back, neck, believe it or not, causes stress and migraine headaches. There's actually a study through the Mayo Clinic that shows that improper pronation can cause stress and migraine headaches. So, really important thing to train is to be able to train what we call foot rolls, going in and out with the feet, okay? And controlling that motion, not just collapsing into it, but controlling it, all right? Because when we walk, we step to the heel, okay? We go to the outside ball of the foot, we pronate to the inside ball of the foot, and then we come through the big toe. Whoop, big toe, there's a big toe. All right, it's really important that your ankles can control that motion. So if you get sideways on here, this is a great one for bunions too. Typically bunions are caused because there's too much pressure on the inside of your foot that causes your big toe to go that way, because now you're using that joint, that first metatarsal, to actually step off of, because there's too much pressure coming in. Working this on MoFlex and keeping your big toe against that first tier will help strengthen that and straighten that toe back out again. Really great exercise. I've got other great exercises. If anyone has a bunion or what I call a ducted toe coming in, let me know, because I can show you some things. It's actually an abducted toe. It's actually turning out from the midline, but a lot of people say abducted. Okay, so we're gonna roll the feet to the side, okay? Holding that arch and then coming back in. This is what we call one of the short foot exercises, and coming back in. This teaches us to control ankle motion, and controlling that will give us greater balance and stability if we're doing yoga, if we're walking. Walking is single leg balance, people. All we're doing is we're transferring weight from one side to the other. Golfing is single leg balance when we're transferring weight from one side to the other. Balance is so critical to everything that we do. Out and in, going out and in. When you get to the end, try to really turn that the outside of the feet are actually turning up. We call this eversion. Really feel that eversion. and that pressure to the inside. Most people have pressure to the inside or pressure to the outside. To really feel that working, Moflex, as I'm showing right now, is very restorative and corrective. It can be used for exercise too. You can go on our YouTube page or our website. You can see all kinds of crazy exercises that we do with it. And I'm sure you've experienced a bunch if you've trained with any of my trainers at the club. And back out, let's go in again, two, let's go one more. Now I brought up the word lunge before. Now if there's any exercise you guys like me to show, let me know. We're running towards the end here. Next exercise is lunge. So a lot of people say, well, I don't understand foot pressure and lunging. So if my front foot is here and I go to step two to make a lunge, you need a certain pressure. Let's do reverse lunge first. So if I'm stepping back, I'm holding my foot on the front here. I'm stepping back with the toes and I'm lowering down. My pressure is in my heel on the front foot. Always in the heel of the front foot until I take a step through. So if I'm lunging, when I step back, I want my pressure on the ball of the back foot, which you might not be able to see. My ball of the back foot's there, and the heel of the front foot. Okay? Now if I'm stepping to the Moflex, you're gonna step to it and do the same thing. Heel load, okay, great way to train. Ball the foot in the back and lower down. Don't raise too far through it. Control that motion of the body again. Does a really great job of controlling motion. We're all getting older, unfortunately, and we wanna save our joints the best we can. And exercise is one of the leading causes of joint deterioration. Not because it's exercise, because it's exercise done wrong, okay? So when you don't do or pressure correctly, you're straining those joints, really important. So if you did a step to lunge here, I'm gonna try to get right to the edge here, so you guys can get me the whole camera here. Let's practice some lunges where you're stepping in. Whoop, I almost lost my balance. Stepping down, pressure's in my heel, ball of foot in the back. Let's alternate. Down. It'll really teach you to work the muscles correctly. What's really wonderful, when we load correctly, like I said before, we activate, ideally. And so when we activate the muscles above the feet and ankles, we get the most response. So the glutes, let's tone up those glutes. When you step properly, you're gonna get full activation of the glutes. When you step into the ball of foot, no activation in the glutes. Why are my glutes not getting stronger, which is really important for your lower back and the way we look? Really important, because if you're at the ball of your foot, you're working your quads. You're not working your glutes. And tight quads and overstrengthened quads lead to bad backs. All right, so there's alternating lunges. All right, I'm gonna stop there today. I just really wanted to give everybody kind of an intro on how to use it. I'll be back to show more, or one of us, any of us trainers, and we'll show you different workouts that you can actually do on the Moflex. We can do balance things. We can do all kinds of sporting ones. Please let us know what ones you'd like to see. If you'd like to see a high intensity impact one, if you're suffering from plantar fasciitis or something else, let me know that. I'll show you exactly what to do on it for that. If you wanted to improve your golf swing, we can do a golf one. Whatever it is that you want to use your Moflex for, let us know. And we'll show you exactly how to do it. So if there's no more questions, do you have any questions? Thanks everybody for taking the time out. I hope everybody is doing well. I'm going stir crazy, but hey, that's just me. I can't stop moving. But I hope everybody's enjoying what we've been putting out there, these live classes, these workouts. Thank you so much for supporting us as a club. It means so much to us that we keep this community together, because together we're stronger through all of this. And we look forward to our next broadcast, and everybody be well. Thank you so much.